はようございます。
おはようございます。
英語がわかりますか？
英語わかります。 I went to an international school from since I was little, so I speak English fluently. Yes.
Hey, so thank you. This is such a treat, and I have to be honest, I was thinking that we were going to have our dogs with us.
Oh.
Because I see on Instagram with your dog.
Which dog do you have?
I have a Bernedoodle. And so I feel like on your Instagram, you have a doodle of some sort.
Yes, I do.
What kind of dog is it?
Labradoodle. It's a mix between Labrador and a poodle. And there's one large and one small.
You have two dogs.
I have five dogs.
Holy wow.
Yeah.
That is insane. How do you find time to practice with so many dogs in the house? I mean, do they come and sit at your feet when you play? Or like, what do the dogs do when you play flute, when you practice?
When I play the flute, for the first 10 minutes or so, my dog really barks. They bark a lot and they howl. I don't know why they do that, but they howl a lot. Like wolves. when I practice. Yeah.
But they're inspired. They want to play with you.
Yeah, and when I play the piano or like practice normally, they usually come sit by my feet and they sleep.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
So do you practice the flute or the piano more depending on your dogs? What do you prefer to play more?
The flute, of course, because it's my
That's great. That's great. How did you start playing the flute? How did it all begin? Where did you get the inspiration for playing the flute?
Do you know Studio Ghibli? Like, it's a Japanese animation film.
Okay.
Like Howl's Moving Castle and like Spirited Away.
Yeah.
From Studio Ghibli, I got the inspiration of music from a film. And I started the violin from that. And when I listened to, I think it was Aquarium, I got the feeling that I really liked the sound of flute. And that's when I started to learn it. And yeah, I think my music is like I got all the inspiration from Japanese anime, Studio Ghibli.
So this is an interesting question. I've never been able to speak about this with someone before. When you know how they learn an instrument or what inspired them to learn an instrument, was there something in particular about the scene of the movie that made you feel really good, and it happened to be because of the flute, and so you were drawn to learning to play the flute because of that emotion from the film? Is that what the inspiration was?
Like, the main character was so obsessed in something, and that happened to be music.
Mm-hmm.
So I was really touched by the fact that someone can actually be like so obsessed in something, and yeah, I think it was just that the fact that I just got really moved and touched by the main character. I think that's only the reason why. I'm not sure, but yeah.
No, I mean, that's really beautiful. And if you think about it, you know, with Stay, the song that we did, the idea of the song came from inviting other people to find just a few moments each day of something that they wanted to hold on to, they wanted to be obsessed with, right?
That's really beautiful.
Be it you know, having time with a friend, you know, over tea or over coffee, or, you know, perhaps just reading a book by yourself, but just, you know, finding those little moments throughout the day that are just strictly yours and no one else's. Walking five dogs, if that brings you life, then that's your stay. And it's interesting because when we were talking about finding someone to collaborate with the song, you know, I've always worked with string players, you know, and I come from a jazz background. So it was like bass and drums. And when your name was brought up, I was just like, that would be amazing. I've never worked with, you know, a flautist before. And so I was just so intrigued, and I was like, this is going to be tremendous. And so when I heard the recording afterwards, it was perfect. You were the perfect person for this song, for this collaboration. There could not have been anyone else that would have done exactly what you brought to this piece. Because there are a lot of people that are technically proficient, that are really great in how they play and their ability, and they can read music really well, but not all of those people know how to play with feeling. And that feeling comes from being obsessed, but not obsessed in a technical mindset, but obsessed by watching a film, seeing a piece of art. And you have that. And so when I heard the recording of your playing it, your tone, the technique was spot on great, but it was what you brought emotionally to the piece that just made me say, there's nothing better than this. This was perfect for what this piece was looking for. So I just wanted to say thank you, because you brought such new life and new color to this piece that wasn't there before. So thank you. Do you have, besides walking the dogs and watching anime, do you have other stays for you that you try to do either each day or maybe each week, or something that just allows you to maybe leave the flute for a little bit or leave the piano for a little bit, and then allows you to kind of find inspiration somewhere else?
I meditate under the sun for about 3 to 8 minutes every day now. And I just try to look at myself from the bird's eye view. And just, I don't know what I do, but I think I plan about the day. And I try to set up a learning objective for the day. In the morning, I meditate. It really changed my daily life, actually. It's become more, I don't know how to say this, but kind of, I couldn't get out of bed, but now I can do that easily. It's changed me a lot.
That's amazing. Sing? You probably sing, don't you? Do you sing? Are you gonna like start singing now?
No.
do you sing? Okay. Well, I mean, you know, because you model, you flute, you play piano and you're in university, I'm just expecting you to say, yes, I'm a professional singer also.
but we take classical singing for 1 year.
There you go. Well, so you know this better than I do.
No, then. I don't.
But like how important just like melody and breathing is, right? As far as like breathing is concerned, like where all of that comes back to the core of everything that we do as creatives, which is emotion. And I think that's amazing that you have all of these backgrounds and then you're continuing to study with someone that at the core of all of this, when you learn everything that you're learning, and then when you stand on that stage to play in front of all of those people, you're going to forget all about the technique. You're going to forget about all the hours of practicing that you just wanted to throw your flute away, because I wanted to quit so many times. And when you're on that stage and you're playing your instrument and you look out at those people, the only thing they hear is your heart. That's it. They don't hear the hours of technique. They don't hear the living in a room by yourself for hours a day with howling dogs as you try to practice. They don't hear those things. All they hear is where they were the first moment they heard your song and how it made them feel. And for me, that is a powerful thing. And you do it tremendously well. And I cannot wait to see.
The words you gave me, it's just so touching that I just want to write that in my notes and make that my lock screen for my phone to look at every day.
So my biggest question is, how do you sleep? Do you even sleep? With all you're doing, do you even sleep more than 2 hours a night?
A lot.
How do you sleep?
I sleep a lot.
You sleep a lot?
Yes.
How are you human?
My sister usually wakes me up, like, she, calls me on the phone to wake up, hurry up.
So you have no problem sleeping with all... Well, I guess that makes sense with everything that you're doing.
I love sleeping.
You love sleeping?
Yeah.
Do you ever have a hard time falling asleep?
No, I always sleep well. Well.
Okay, that's good. All right. Because I was just thinking, how do you do everything in your day? Then I was thinking that you don't sleep, but... Once again, you've proved me wrong, and so,
that's... But before I sleep, I have to listen to classical music.
Hmm.
Yeah, it's my daily routine, and I also listen to whales.
Like the animals?
As in the animal, yeah.
Really?
I really like the sound of whales, so I listen to...
This is a recording, correct? You don't have whales in your room.
No, it's a recording. I just search it up on YouTube and listen to it every day.
That's an awesome idea. What gave you that idea?
Weird,
I'm super curious. What gave you that idea?
I don't know. I just heard it on Animal Planet or something, on BBC or something. And I really like the sound of whales.
I'm going to look for that tonight. That's That is a new one for me. Is the whale your favorite animal besides dogs?
My favorite animal is owls.
Owls.
Yeah.
How come?
I really like how they hunt silently, yet so elegantly, beautifully. Yeah.
It's going back to this whole obsession thing then. That's tremendous. So, well, I'm curious. I will look up the owl. The whales. Then I will check that out. That sounds really fascinating, to be honest. So, I will have to look that up. Well, I really appreciate you just taking the time, and just it's as difficult as it is to not be in person. At least we can connect and just say hello over Zoom and just connect this way. Kind of like how we recorded, we were oceans apart, to be honest. So I think it's amazing what the pandemic has kind of made people do in a roundabout way, which is be really creative and how they continue moving forward. I mean, just for us to be able to create on the other side of the world is tremendous. And then for us to be able to just talk on the other side of the world, I think it's just really great. So meanwhile, I will continue working on my Japanese, then, my Nihongo ga. So I will continue to work on that. Yes, exactly. If you have any tips, just send them over while I listen to whales at night, trying to fall asleep, listening to Japanese whales, trying to... talk me to sleep at night. So, well, thank you so much for your time today. I really appreciate it. And I'm really looking forward to hopefully playing this song together. I think it'd be a lot of fun to be able to play this live in person.
Thank you so much. I really loved your music. And whenever I had the time to, I searched up on the internet and YouTube to look and listen to your songs. Pieces. It was really relaxing. Thank you.
Okay. That means the world. Thank you very much. I'm excited to be working with you.
Me too. Thank you.